Four winners have shared in tonight's record $100 million Oz Lotto jackpot. Sean Salby joins us live from Melbourne. Sean, can you do the maths for us? How much do they get?
Well, Hermione, the four lucky Australians each win $27,993,037.76. It's a massive number, and they each shared the $111 million mega jackpot. Now, there's a winner from New South Wales, there's a winner from Queensland, and two winners from Victoria. The good news is that this money will hopefully transform the lives of the people who have won and give them some happiness. But the bad news for everybody else is that, unfortunately, next Tuesday night's Oz Lotto will go back to just $2 million. Now, it seemed this week the Oz Lotto fever swept the nation with 8 million tickets purchased throughout Australia for tonight's draw. And here in Melbourne, although it was a Melbourne Cup public holiday, the Lotto agencies opened just because of the demand, and they say it was some of the busiest scenes that they've ever had. And they say it was so busy that the website actually crashed today with so many people trying to check their numbers. So unfortunately for those people like myself who couldn't tip a winner in the Melbourne Cup and certainly didn't win a dime in tonight's Oz Lotto, it seems that it's back to the drawing board. But $2 million next Tuesday, it's a far cry from $111 million which was given out tonight. But it's still not bad, Hermione.
Absolutely. Thank you, Sean Salby in Melbourne. Well, the celebrations are continuing tonight for the connections of Melbourne Cup winner Green Moon. Despite the soggy weather, 100,000 people flocked to Flemington Racecourse to watch the race, among them Prince Charles and Camilla. It was a clear fourth win for owner Lloyd Williams.
I'm just so proud for all our team at the farm. Yeah, it's another Melbourne Cup triumph for Team Williams, and I'm just ecstatic.
We'll have a full wrap-up of the day's events on and off the track a little later in the show. Julia Gillard didn't let being in Laos with world leaders stop her from having some Cup Day fun. The Prime Minister cheered on the horses at a special function at the Australian Embassy with staff and family members. Her pick was a Mary Kane, but she didn't come up trumps in this race. Tomorrow, Ms Gillard heads to the Bali Democracy Forum. Well, if you backed an interest rate cut, you were sadly disappointed. Political reporter Matt Moran joins us live from Canberra. Matt, why didn't the Reserve make any move this time around?
Well, we can put it down to slightly higher inflation data. And to be honest, the world economy was also slightly stronger, which played a part. Now, this is the first time in 7 years that the Reserve Bank has not cut interest rates on Melbourne Cup Day. So not particularly good news there for homeowners. Let's have a listen to what Julia Gillard had to say about this.
We have a strong economy. Our fiscal strategy is right, and it is right to give the Reserve Bank the maximum room to move should it choose to do so. A family with a $300,000 a year mortgage is $4,500 better off a year under this government as a result of lower interest rates.
Business is clearly disappointed with respect to the decision by the Reserve Bank today. Given the what we saw as evident weakness in the economy.
Now, Greg Evans believes we could see a rate cut in December, but the ANZ believes the RBA may wait and reassess in February.
OK, thank you, Matt Moran in Canberra. An 8-year-old boy has died in a Sydney hospital tonight after being found unconscious in a backyard pool. The boy was reported missing this afternoon and was found in the pool at Roseville. He was rushed to hospital but couldn't be revived. Two men have died after their car struck a tree in Melbourne's northeast. The sedan left the road, killing one man instantly and trapping the other. Rescue crews spent 2 hours freeing the passenger, but he also died at the scene.
Pretty severe accident, one of the worst ones we've been to take someone out of a car.
A report is being prepared for the coroner. A grandmother has fought off an attack by a vicious dog by biting it on the ear. 72-year-old Lynette Norman suffered injuries to her arms and fingers after the Rottweiler knocked her down to get to her pet Jack Russell. She says she had no option but to fight back.
I just bit down on his ear and I thought, if I tear his ear off, good. At least he's hurt him.
The bite worked, the dog retreated, but sadly, Lady did not survive. Arch-rivals Holden and Ford have united to ensure a major Australian car parts supplier remains open. The car giants are paying off Autodom's $6.5 million debt. The company closed its doors and stood down 400 workers at its Victorian and South Australian plants last week. The receivers will work with the unions to limit disruptions. The mother of a missing toddler has been quizzed about inconsistent evidence at an inquest into her disappearance. One-year-old Rama el-Dennaoui disappeared from her Sydney home in 2005. Police thought she had been abducted, but now believe there was a cover-up. Today, Mrs. el-Dennaoui broke down, insisting they've done nothing wrong. But the coroner said she found it hard to reconcile her emotion with telephone recordings where she joked about Rama's disappearance. An Australian scientist had discovered a drug that could kill superbugs. Dr. Ramas Boulos used computer modelling and lab testing to uncover the non-toxic drug that binds and kills bacteria. It also is effective against golden staph. It's hoped a pharmaceutical company will now fund more testing. And proving age is just a number, 85-year-old priest Tim Harrison has scaled down per St George's Cathedral Tower to highlight the importance of keeping active. The grandfather, who's also jumped out of a plane, hadn't abseiled since 1944 when he was in the British Army.
That's the way.
It just reminds me that I'm still quite young. I'm a bit stiff, but it reminds me I've got to do something about the next 15 years.
Mr. Harrison wants to take on the challenge again next year. A quick look at the weather across the country. Tonight it's currently 25 degrees in Townsville, 20 in Brisbane, 21 in Sydney, 18 degrees in Melbourne, 16 in Adelaide, 18 in Perth.